Good morning, students. Have you remembered last class what we studied? I hope you all would have thorough yourself in the first and the second application of Gauss law. Last class we studied what is the expression for electric field due to infinitely large plane sheet which carries a positive charge. In today's class, the same thing, certain special cases we have to study, and the next one is the next application, electric field due to uniformly charged spherical shell. So these two are the materials or the concepts what we are going to study. Okay, quick review of previous class. Infinite plane sheet, it carries positive charge. And can anyone say what is the expression for electric field? Yes, the expression for electric field is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Remember, the electric field due to the sheet is independent of distance. Distance is immaterial here. An n cap here, it gives the direction of the electric field vector. If it is positive charge, from the positive charge. If it is a negative charge, it is towards the negative charge. Yesterday I stopped the class here and I asked you to find out what is the expression for electric field at the point P1 due to this arrangement. I hope you all would have got the answer correctly. Now we will see what is that one. Now, so far we studied, if I take it, only one sheet we have taken. What is the expression for electric field due to this positively charged sheet? Is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Now, instead of having one sheet, now today we will have two sheets. One is positively charged, another one is negatively charged. The surface charge density of the positively charged is plus sigma, and the surface charge density of the negatively charged plate is minus sigma. Now, we will divide this arrangement into three regions. The region 1 is the point P1. Region 2 is point P2. Region 3 is point P3. Now my aim is I want to find out what is the expression for electric field at the point P1, at the point P2 and at the point P3. This is the way in which I want to find out what is the expression for electric field. Now see, let us take first the point P3, convenience sake. Okay, take only the point P3. Here you take it. Now see, due to the positively charged plate, the electric field. What is the electric field due to the positively charged plate? Positively charged plate will give the electric field in this direction, in this direction. Suppose if I go here also, the electric field will be in the same direction. So the electric field due to the positive charge at the point P3 is this one. Suppose if I go to the point P1, the electric field is this one, towards the right side, positive x-axis, and here. So these three are the directions of the electric field. The arrow is given with the lavender color, violet color it is given. Now, we are going to see what is the electric field due to the negative charge, negatively charged plate. You all know very well, negatively charged plate, electric field is towards. So for this arrangement, negatively charged plate means, so the electric field due to the negative charge, can you see here, it is towards the plate. And in this place you see the electric field due to the negative charge is towards, the blue color arrow it shows. And here you see it is shown in this direction. Can you see here the electric field? So each case, each point, the electric fields are acting in different directions. So what is the total expression for electric field at the point P1, at the point P2, at the point P3 I have to see. Now see here in this region, that is in this place, both the electric field due to positive and negative charge are acting in opposite direction. In P2 point, they are acting in opposite direction. But if you take the region P1, the electric field is due to positive as well as negative charges acting in the same direction. Are you clear? Yes. Now we will move on to the next one. Now the same diagram, slightly in a different way I have given. just the charges are not marked. I named as sheet 1, sheet 2. Sheet 1 is positively charged, sheet 2 is negatively charged. If the sheet 1 is positively charged, due to the positive charge, the electric field due to the positive charge, here it is outward. And here from the positive charge outward. And due to the positive charged plate, electric field is outward. So these three, the circles, green color circles, what I have marked are the electric field due to the positively charged plate. Same manner, if I take the negatively charged plate, the electric field due to the negatively charged plate is, that is sheet 2, I named it as, it is E2. And here it is E2 towards. And in the third case, E2 towards. These three are the electric fields due to the negatively charged plates. So what is a net field? See here. Here both are acting. That is, if I take it, here both are acting in the opposite direction. And if you consider both the electric fields are acting in the same direction. But here if you see, they are acting in the opposite direction. So what is the total electric field here? It is due to the sum of E1 plus E2. One is positive, another one is negative. Because the surface charge density for both the values are, one is plus and another one is minus. There is no difference. Magnitude wise, they are same. This is plus, for example, you take it as plus 53 coulomb per meter square. This is minus 53 coulomb per meter square. So the total value, if I find out here, it is equivalent to 0. Same thing here, it is equivalent to 0. But here, both are acting in the same direction. So you have to add both the values to get the total value. Are you clear? So what is the total electric field? Using this idea, can you say? What is the expression for electric field at the point P2? What is the electric field at the point P3? Both are having same surface charge density. Can you recall the previous diagram? And you can say, yes, you are right. So the electric field in the middle region alone, due to the positive charge, we know already sigma by 2 epsilon naught, due to the negative charge, both are in the same direction. So simple addition, the answer is sigma by epsilon naught. So what we are getting is, due to one single sheet, the electric field is sigma by 2 epsilon naught. One is positive, another one is negative, the electric field is sigma by epsilon naught. The electric field due to two sheets are kept like this means the resultant electric field is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. Now, the next application, instead of taking here, both are of the same plus sigma and minus sigma, previous case we have taken. Now I have taken two positively charged plates, but one is, the blue one is having surface charge density sigma 1, the orange one is surface charge density sigma 2. So what is the resultant electric field due to this arrangement? Now both are positive, remember. It is not a negative one, both are positive. So positive means from the sheet it will act. What is the expression for electric field we have to see. Now see, due to the positive sheet, that is the first sheet, electric field is this side and this side. Same manner, if I have to take it, what is the electric field due to the negative, the second sheet is E2, that is the orange sheet is outward, and here it is outward, and here it is outward. So what is the total electric field in region 1, region 2, region 3? I have to find out. And already it is given, the surface charge density of sigma 1 is greater than sigma 2. So now I have to find out what is the total electric field in region 1. You see, E1 is towards left, E2 is towards left. So what is the total electric field is sum of E1 plus E2. So which is equal to sigma 1 by epsilon naught plus sigma 2 by epsilon naught. Add both the things, you will get this as the answer. Same manner, in region 3 also, the same method, both are acting in this direction. But if you come to the middle region, if you see, E1 is acting which direction? Positive x-axis. E2 is acting which direction? Negative x-axis. Normally positive x-axis we will take it as the value is positive side. So the resultant electric field in this one we are getting it as E1 minus E2. Substitute the value of sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So it becomes sigma 1 by 2 epsilon naught minus sigma 2 by 2 epsilon naught. So what is the resultant one? Resultant one is equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 2 by epsilon naught. I hope you are clear about application of Gauss law for this. This way you will get many questions, children. They will give the diagram or they may give the value. They may ask you to calculate what is the expression for electric field at the point 1, at the point region 2, region 3 by giving the value, where it increases, where it is high. We may apply this one. So please understand and study. So next one is electric field due to uniformly charged spherical shell. This is what we have to study in the next class. So that I will take it in the next class. Time is, they asked us to give you a short video only, not as a long video. So the electric field due to charged spherical shell, I will give it shortly in the next video. So please study this part, and I request all of you to send the assignments, whatever I have sent it to my mail ID. Thank you, children.